Hello everyone. Today we are going to study about glycogenolysis. Glycogenolysis means breakdown of glycogen to glucose 6-phosphate or glucose. Takes place in the cytoplasm of the cell. You should remember glycogenolysis is not just reversal of glycogenesis because there are separate group of enzymes present in the cytoplasm for glycogenesis and glycogenolysis. The essential requirements for glycogenolysis is the rate limiting enzyme glycogen phosphorylase and the deep branching enzyme on coenzyme pyridoxal phosphate. Let us study the process of breakdown of glycogen or glycogenolysis. We all know that glycogen is highly branched. We'll observe the branch every 6 to 7 glucose residues. And all these are alpha 1,4 and the branching point is alpha 1,6. For the sake of explanation, I won't show entire glycogen molecule. Just I will take a portion of glycogen in order to explain the steps of glycogen breakdown. Please remember, I have not taken entire glycogen molecule. I have taken a small portion of glycogen for the explanation. All these are alpha 1,4 glycosidic linkage and in the branching point alpha 1,6. Now the rate limiting enzyme for breakdown of glycogen is glycogen phosphorylase. Okay, so it requires inorganic phosphate. So the glucose from the terminal end or non-reducing end removed as glucose 1-phosphate. So where is this phosphate is coming from? This inorganic phosphate. So the glycogen phosphorylase removes glucose one by one from the non-reducing end of the glycogen molecule as glucose 1-phosphate. Now glucose 1-phosphate isomerized to glucose 6-phosphate with the help of enzyme phosphoglucomutase. Please remember, this is the end product in muscle. So glycogen broken down to glucose 6-phosphate and it will enter glycolysis and produce ATP. In liver, this glucose 1-phosphate can be converted to glucose with the help of glucose 6-phosphatase. This enzyme absent in the muscle, so muscle cannot yield glucose, whereas liver glycogen can be converted to glucose and it can give glucose to all other tissue through the peripheral circulation. So liver is the most gangrenous organ because it gives glucose from the glycogen under fasting condition. So in this manner, this glycogen phosphorylase and inorganic phosphate removes glucose one by one to glucose 1-phosphate, glucose 6-phosphate and glucose. You can see here, one by one glucose are removed until there are 4 glucose residues in that particular branch. Now the another important enzyme is called glucon transferase, which removes the terminal 3 glucose residues and breaks this alpha 1,4 glycosidic bond and establishes new alpha 1,4 glycosidic bond here. Okay, it's glucon transferase, also called myelo 1,4 and 1,4 glucon transferase. Now we have a branching point here, alpha 1,6 glycosidic bond. It can be removed by another enzyme called alpha 1,6 glycosidase. So it breaks this alpha 1,6 glycosidic bond and removes p glucose. Please remember, alpha 1 6 glycosidase removes glucose from the alpha 1 6 bond and removes free glucose. Glucose release as free glucose. Now this glucon transferase and alpha 1 6 glycosidase, they are not separate enzyme. In fact, they are a single protein with two enzymatic activity. That means they have two separate active sites. It is also known as bifunctional enzyme. So the name given here is debranching enzyme. Okay, debranching enzyme is a bifunctional enzyme which has got two enzymatic activity. One glucon transferase, another one is 1,6 glycosidase. Now further action by glycogen phosphorylase and inorganic phosphate, it removes glucose one by one from the other branch. So one by one glucose removed as glucose 1 phosphate, glucose 6 phosphate in muscle, glucose in the liver. So this process continues until there are 4 glucose residues in the that particular branch. Now the terminal 3 glucose residues are again removed by glucon transferase and transferred to this growing end, alpha 1 4 to alpha 1 4. Now other enzyme or activity of this debranching enzyme, alpha 1 6 glycosidase, removes or breaks this alpha 1 6 glycosidic bond and releases free glucose. So now we have a straight line with only alpha 1 4 glycosidic linkage. It can be taken care by glycogen phosphorylase and phosphate. So like this, one glucose will be released at a time as glucose 1 phosphate, glucose 6 phosphate in the muscle, glucose in the liver. So please remember, the rate limiting enzyme is glycogen phosphorylase and another important enzyme is debranching enzyme, which is bifunctional enzyme. It has glucon transferase activity and alpha 1 6 glycosidase activity. So why there is no glucose release from the glycogen in the muscle? Because there is no glucose 6 phosphatase enzyme in the muscle, whereas liver can give glucose from the glycogen in fasting condition. So this is with respect to glycogenolysis. Thanks for watching.